For so long I carried the weight of my past, crippled by burdens like stones on my back. I thought I had fallen too far from your grace.
Welcome to Recovery Radio, where we have hope for you today.
When I was lost, so searching, you were the ground beneath my feet. When I was a blind man begging, you were the eye so I could see.
Hey, good morning. Welcome to Worldwide Recovery Radio. I'm your host, Mike, and man, good morning to you, good afternoon to you, good evening, wherever you may be.
Good day. Because,
listen, good day, wherever you are. We just want to say that we've missed you. We took the holidays off, and we took 2 weeks off, and it was very refreshing, and hope the holidays were good for you. We've played some music in our fill-in spot. I know I got texts and comments from like all over the world. What happened to you guys? Where are you? We are back.
Yes, we are back.
Just a little temporary time off for all, and we missed you guys. So we're glad to be back. Hey, I'm here in the studio with my troubled co-host.
Hey now.
Val.
Troubled?
Well, am I troubled because of who the host is?
That could be. But, she's my sidekick who really, I guess, keeps us in line.
She tries,
yeah. And, of course, our engineer this morning, as always, Bill.
Good morning.
Good morning to you. It's good to be back. On the radio. Hope you had a great holiday. Hey, listen, it's a new year.
Yes.
It is 2021.
And, everybody, our prayer is obviously to hopefully for a better year than 2020. We know there's so much sadness in the pandemic and the loss and families and
isolation.
There's so much to it. You know, I experienced it through my wife. She's lost three people in like 3 weeks. And so we're glad to see 2021 coming, but that's here. But it didn't start out too good. A lot of chaos within, you know, government and on and on. So many things. But listen, here's the whole key. Keep your focus on God.
Yes.
Right? Keep your focus on God, because the world is, it's gonna go crazy. It's going to have its ups and downs. But God is the same, you know, thousands of years ago, even up to today, the exact same. And we can always count on him. As a matter of fact, he makes over 7,000 promises, Bill, in the Bible.
I know.
So those are
a lot.
That's a good foundation to stand on. So we hope that you just sit back and relax and enjoy the show today. Mm-hmm. Val, the show is about change. And,
that's right.
And see, I haven't changed yet. I haven't changed with trying to throw you under the bus yet.
Well,
so,
you know.
But it's always a challenge because you're quick and
it's
witty.
It's cute that you try, but.
Yes, I know. Yeah. But change. Boy, it's going to be a lot of fun. So we've got a lot in there. And we hope that you. We hope that you make a phone call to us because it's a live call-in show.
That's right. And I have the phone number right here for you. 1-800-721-9313 or locally 928-855-9110. You can always reach out to us too on our website, recoveryradiolhc.com.
Perfect. Ton of information there.
Yes.
Shout out to a lot of people within our team, Miss Pat, our producer is here, Tom is here, Polly is here, and the rest of the team is just kind of spread apart, and we're going to work on rotation. Today we're in a smaller studio. I apologize.
Great. We're in my studio.
Mike's within striking distance of me.
Yes, I'm worried about her because we're like really close right now. Usually in the big studio,
you're gotta, like 12 feet apart.
Oh, yeah,
she's really got to rely on the Lord's protection
today.
She's got
to throw pins at me to get me. But now I'm like right next to her, so I'm in the danger zone. So why don't you open us up in prayer?
I'd love to. Father God, I thank you today for your mercy, for your grace. I just ask that everyone feels your presence today, that through this show today, that they see that the love that you have for them, that they understand that this year can be new training ground to grow closer to you. And in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. We're thankful for the air team members, and mm-hmm. We had that Share-a-thon in November.
Yeah,
and a lot of good things because the giving was amazing. And listen, they got a brand new studio in Barstow. Is it?
Yeah,
is
we're
it
working on Barstow? That. It's working still in on the works. That.
Yeah,
the contract and paperwork and FCC.
Isn't that amazing?
All that stuff. It takes time.
Oh, but, it does. I know.
It's truly incredible.
That's just amazing. So we're going to be spread out even farther. We'll gather a few more million listeners. Yeah. Yes. Amen.
Love
Amen.
It.
The potential is awesome.
Why don't you, Val? You know, we're thankful for our sponsors.
Oh, yes.
Man, they're amazing.
We wouldn't be here without them.
So that's right. Yeah, I like that. You're exactly right. So why don't you tell the people who they are?
Sure. Easy Rider Motorcycle Testing, now hiring riders, located at 1080 Aviation Drive or by phone 928-706-4553. Ace Pest Control, serving the Lake Havasu City area for 20 years with termite, pest, and weed control. By phone 928-680-0988 or on the web acepestcontrolaz.com. We also have Print at Havasu, black and white or colored copies, graphic design to print. They have souvenirs and Christian gifts located at 2018 McCulloch Boulevard North or by phone 928-505-0451. We'd also like to thank our anonymous sponsor. God knows who you are, and we thank you.
And also, now, Hilltop Church, they provide shirts, hats, and if you call in, you enter in a drawing, and we're going to have Val pick whoever wins today. We'll start the new year off right. So she will, if you call in, you enter into a drawing to win a t-shirt or a hat. Now, Bill doesn't have his t-shirt on, and
it's
he's
in
had
the
a couple of weeks off.
It was a hard one
I forgot
t-shirt.
To, I forgot, and, to, you know, I forgot to wash it.
So. I mean, it took you a year and a half to get it, and you
well,
don't
I want
have
it clean,
on
though,
today.
Too,
yeah,
so.
We want it clean, too. Thank you,
yes.
Bill.
Yes, okay, yeah. So, anyways...
But yes, it is an awesome t-shirt, and you
it really
have
is,
one.
Man. They're great to win
There's
that prize. So we thank you.
I like my hat though too.
I do too.
Yeah.
Good
hats
stuff.
Are good.
Good stuff. Hey, let me tell you what we're about. We're here to maybe encourage you, give you help. We bring all kinds of live testimonies, all kinds of struggles, hurts, habits per se, anything that you identify. We've had people that. Finally quit smoking and the struggle of doing that. And we've had cancer patients and going through chemo and we've had drugs. We've had alcohol. We had PTSD. We had
PTSD.
Yeah, that too. Mm-hmm. Yes, thank you. Mm-hmm. You know, we had Mike on recently with his dog Benson.
Yeah,
and what a testimony
Incredible
that was.
Story.
That was just amazing. So we appreciate that. But we've brought so many things to the table. Hopefully, one of them has infected you or affected you in a way of change.
Yes.
Because that's what we hope to do. Bring you something that enlightens you, maybe turns on a light bulb, and you say, "Wow, if that person can do it, so can I."
Yep.
And you mentioned the website, Val, RecoveryRadioLHC.com. We have so much information on that. It can bring you to past shows. It can give you information, hotline numbers, all kinds of numbers, meeting numbers.
Yeah.
Just so much. We spend a lot of time. And John and Terry, who are home today, we just thank them for taking care of that electronic world because it's so important. They update it. So we're here for you.
Yes.
That's what this program is about. It's not about us. It's not about being on the air to glorify us. It's all about Jesus Christ.
That's
it's about
right.
God, because he's the one that pulled us out of not the best situations. Everyone on this team is so thankful for a newness, a new life, and we're talking about change today. My wife is in behind me in the window dancing because she's so happy. Or I don't know. She's had a cup of coffee this morning, so
well,
maybe that could be too.
Yeah,
so
caffeine, yeah.
But we're here for you, and we'd love to not only electronically, we'd love to hear from you from emails, getting emails. If you're coming through Arizona, to let us know. We'll pass that on to our producer, Pat, and you can have conversation. We'd love to have you as a guest.
Absolutely.
Right?
Yep.
Or to, you know, a lot of people, Bill, we get a lot of calls. Sometimes most people don't want to go on air.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I didn't realize how much that was, but most people have called in or text or do it electronically. Now, we're not live streaming today, but when we live stream, names and information scrolls up the whole time, and people say, thank you for the show, listening in, you know, Australia, yeah. Africa, love the show, and on and on. And then we get emails for prayer requests and what have you. So we monitor that all the time and answer emails, you know, whether it be a praise report, we'd love to put it on the air. Again, this show is all about you. And so just a little bit of information in ways that you can get a hold of us and contact us.
Yep, that's right. And what we're not about, and I want you all to hear this, Jesus Christ transformed my life. So the important part of that sentence is it's done with Jesus Christ. We cannot fix each other. Only Jesus can.
Yeah.
We're to support one another, lift each other up, speak life into one another, pray for each other. But only Jesus has the power to change a heart, a mind, and an action.
Yeah. Yeah, because you were a mess.
I was a mess, y'all.
So, yes.
You weren't, though. You were always walking straight, never had any problems.
I've never really had any issues or anything, so.
Wow, you need an altar, buddy.
There's a group for that.
let me tell you, I call myself, folks, the worst of the worst. You know, the people that know me know that I'm simply joking, but I call myself the worst of the worst because I was out there for 34 years and pure wicked.
Yeah.
And dancing with the devil. I mean, there's only two sides of the fence. You know, people say I'm sitting on the fence. Well, you can't sit on the fence
because
it's pointy most of the time anyways. Yeah. And you got to make a choice.
Right.
So you're either with him or against him. There's only two ways. There's no gray area, which I like. I mean, scripture is cut and dry.
Yeah.
And it's made that way because people will try and distort it or water it down. And it is what it is.
Mm-hmm.
And
very true.
The devil likes to confuse.
Oh, yeah,
right?
Big time.
So that's not from the Lord. That's from
scripture,
the evil one.
Too.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I mean, he even tried that with Jesus.
Yep.
It didn't work, but that's our example.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
you know, good things we hope that today. Our topic being change, and we got all kinds of stuff to talk about. And hopefully now, we'd love to hear from you because, you know, we're not going to say this is a New Year's resolution and all that stuff. This is a personal challenge that you've given yourself. Maybe God has given it to you. Maybe someone else spoke into your life and said, you know, I noticed this about you, that you do this.
Yeah.
And you take a look at it and say, you know, I'd like to change that.
Yeah.
I'd like to work on that. I could be better at that. Maybe you're already good at something and you're aspiring to be better at it this year.
Mm-hmm.
Like my golf game.
Wow.
So,
good luck with that.
Yes, I agree. Yeah, that's not going to happen. But see what I mean? It's just it could be just one simple goal.
Yeah,
that's all it could be. Just one simple goal for change.
Yes, that's how God created us. He's filling us with this wisdom and with these insights and with His love to give it away, not to keep it and hold on to it.
Yes,
He wants us to share it with people. So I encourage people to call us at 1-800-721-9313.
And the local number, 928-855-9110. What's our scripture for today? Actually, the scripture today you just said, that is in your testimony.
It is.
And it makes you smile.
Ooh, yes. So it's Isaiah 43:19. Behold, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? I will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert.
Wow. Pretty good stuff right there.
That's good. Yeah,
that's pretty good
Mic
stuff.
Mic drop. Boom.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, God says it all, you know, in him. So it's... We want to do a shout out this morning. We miss you guys, Aaron and the boys, listening, and we get to go into the airwaves of a prison, and we received a letter from Aaron, and it made us all smile. Aaron, thank you so much. We love you. We miss you. It's just amazing what God can do. Maybe many of you can relate, you know, being in prison, not being in prison, being captured, not captured. But when God, I tell you, when God gets your attention, you change.
Yep.
If you're willing to, you know, kind of follow that path or that direction, it is absolutely amazing what takes place, transformations. And so it's really... it was refreshing to hear what you're doing, Aaron, with what God is doing in your life. Shout out to all those men in prison. We love you.
Yes.
And
his life is a perfect example of God can reach anyone, anywhere, and you can make an impact no matter where you are.
Yes, I like that. Yes. No matter where you are. And, you know, a lot of people say, well, it's not the right time, or I'm waiting for the right time. You know, they're looking for that perfect moment, or they think this and that.
Not going
to
happen.
That's right. It's not going to happen. And I think the best time to change is at the worst time.
Yes.
Right?
That's right.
Isn't
Amen
that true?
To that.
Isn't that true?
It's the perfect time to do it.
I know it was for me, talking about suicide, really thinking about it, having it capture your thought process, and boom, God put somebody in your life. And I said, okay.
And change doesn't have to be this huge, you know, Mike's story is pretty powerful, where he was once, you know, contemplating suicide to being rescued and sharing this, sharing his faith and sharing hope with everybody. It can be something as small as you struggle with fear. Mm-hmm. You struggle with anxiety. It doesn't have to be this, like, very, you know, black and white, like, whoa, my story can't be as powerful as that, so I can't share it. That is so not true, because there's more people who struggle with those things that maybe some people think are smaller, but they're really not.
No, they're big to them.
Yes.
But they're, it's an issue that somehow affects their life.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, just a little thing of anxiety.
Yeah,
you know, people say, oh, I'm just a little bit nervous, and they struggle with that anxiety. Well, that anxiety freezes people, and it captures them. And for them, it's it's so big.
Yes.
But to so many other people, they just say, well, I'll just get out of that, or just make a change and do that. And it's almost paralyzing for them. So, you know, everyone is different. Everybody's struggle. Everybody's challenge. My story has boulders in it. Your story may just have little sand pebbles in it. But you see, it's your story. It's your challenge. It's your struggle.
That's right.
It's not anybody else's. A lot of times that affects our family, our struggles, and not being willing to change just get into surrendering to make that change. But other people get stuck. So
yeah, looks like we have a caller, Mike, on line one.
Yep,
line one. Good morning. Welcome to Recovery Radio.
Hey, Sherry, how are you?
Sherry, how are you? Good morning. Happy New Year.
Happy 2021.
Yes.
Good to hear you guys on the radio again.
Yes, it's good to be back. I'll tell you, we missed our Saturdays, and next year I think we'll do a replay this year. We just played some new Christmas music, so next year we'll have that filled in.
That's right.
Yeah. So tell us, Sherry, what's something that you've been given the inkling to maybe change, or look at working on changing?
Well, so I was diagnosed with COVID December 22nd, which was a such, it was a, an opportunity to spend time with the Lord for 10 days, just me and the Lord. So I sat on my patio by myself and just prayed and journaled every day. And the Lord gave me revelation that procrastination is what I need to work on. And I've lived here in this city for about 5 years, and I've had this shed filled with boxes of stuff from where I moved. And the Lord said we need to focus on cleaning that up. So I started cleaning. I just sit on a chair, go through a box or a bag, you know, take my time, not be strenuous or anything because I was, you know, diagnosed with COVID at the time. And in 2015, I went to Israel with our church, and I bought a necklace with a cross for my daughter. Well, then we moved here, and she misplaced it. She had no idea where it was. Well, as I'm going through this box and I go through every little thing, guess what I find?
The necklace.
The cross from Israel.
That's awesome.
That I gave my daughter.
Wow.
So, so God totally blessed me by doing that simple thing of cleaning and decluttering. And I just wanted to share that praise report that God has a purpose and a plan that we can't even imagine. And he will wow us with the small things, and he cares for the big things as well as the small things.
Yeah, you know, Sherry, I use that correlation a lot, is that he wants to clean, he wants us to clean up our own mess. And a lot of times our mess is with inside of us, and we have to, you know, go in and kind of dig deep, and you know, it's like cleaning a closet, and it's a, it's a mess. But through that, we it's amazing the blessings and rewards and the newness. It's like, I don't know, replacing kind of stagnant water or stale water, and you clean it all out, put fresh, crystal clear water in it, and it's refreshing, and there's a newness to it.
Rivers in the desert, Mike.
Yeah, I like that. Back to the rivers in the desert. He just, he does that to us, man. So, well, that's, we're glad. Now, are you feeling better?
Oh, I'm almost 100%, yes.
Yeah,
and
amen.
Little by little, I've been cleaning the shed, and little by little, I've been finding just, it's a healing process, and like you said, it's freedom. I've been giving stuff away to Goodwill. I've been throwing things out every day. I've been just cleaning everything, and it's healing. I found, so my mom passed away 8 years ago, and I found cards from her, and it's just been a blessing. So like you said, it's freedom. And a wise man once told me there's healing and revealing. And when the things are revealed, boy, it's so healing, and it's just freedom and newness, like you said, and it's awesome. So I'm so thankful and grateful today for today.
Amen. Good job, Sherry.
Yes, thank you so much for calling and sharing
that. Great. See that?
Really thank you.
Cleaning
out
of shit. Yeah. Amen. Amen. Thank
you,
Sherry.
God bless.
You know what
bless.
I love about that about that story she just shared is that God spoke to her and she listened, and obedience was blessed by that. Just an example of that, you know, a small example.
Yeah.
But what does God do when we're obedient in the big things in life?
Yeah.
Like, it's time to put down that drink.
Yeah.
It's time to stop abusing so-and-so. It's time to change your anger into love.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Yeah. Good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Good stuff.
Yeah.
And, you know, we change, and then our family sees the effect of the change. And what a blessing.
Yeah.
I mean, it's, I say it all the time, it's win-win. So we'd love to hear from you this morning. Our topic is change. What's going on in your life? What you would like to see yourself begin? Even just beginning the process is change.
Yep.
Right.
Absolutely.
Just to say, I would like to work on this.
Mm-hmm.
That's change.
Ooh,
that's the beginning of talking about. Change, and then you by taking the action, you begin to change whatever it is.
Mm-hmm.
It could be eating habits,
mm-hmm.
you know. It could be I'm gonna work on watching what I do, watching what I eat, maybe a little bit of exercise, maybe a little bit more reading, reading scripture, maybe reading a devotional. Maybe I'm going to work on praying, maybe a little bit more prayer within your life. I want to see how this works. And is there a God? I'm going to challenge him this year. Is he really real? As they talk about on Recovery Radio, is change possible? I mean, have all those people been through so many challenges and struggles that they had to turn to God to fix them? Why couldn't you fix yourself? You know, change takes form in many different ways. And just taking a step forward and maybe instead of step back, you will begin to change. And God will show up in a newness. You know, Val, I told you a story before we went on the air. And, you know, many of us also are creatures of habit.
Yeah.
True
that. Where we, I don't care what you do, that doesn't need to change, you know. And I remember years ago, I walked into this church in Florida, and I had been part of that for a number of years. And I was just a greeter.
Yeah.
And I would come at least an hour early, and I'd bring my Bible. And there's 1,800 seats in this church. and I would walk up, and I would put mine on the floor corner, back corner. And that's where I sat all the time for like years. And everybody knew where I sat, and we had this gathering and stuff like that. And, well, I walked into the church one day, and it was at least an hour and a half early, and there's a woman in my seat. Now, there's 1,800 seats, and the first thing I started to do was, she is in my seat. Well, why is she in my seat? There's 1,800 seats. She has to pick mine. So I'm like, okay, do I go up and tell her, by the way, this is my seat. Maybe can you move over? Or we have a section of people. And I'm just a little bit of a rebel, just a little bit. And so I thought, okay, I'm going to sit right next to her then. So I walked up and I said hello, and I put my Bible right next to her. Now, I can imagine what she thought. There's 1,800 seats, and this guy has got to put his Bible right next to me. There's all of these seats, right? And I just, we're creatures of habit.
Yep, yep.
And we get into that role of, maybe you're laughing, but maybe that's you.
Yeah.
I sit in the same seat all the time. Maybe people do that all the time.
How dare they sit in mine?
And that's mine. Yeah, like we take ownership of
it. And you know what I love about this story is that this is how God works in my life. He changes my heart. And when I'm following my same habits and something like that happens, am I stopped dead in my tracks and going, okay, what is the Lord trying to teach me here? That's not something I used to question. I just would, hey, you're sitting in my seat, bro. Move out of the way.
Yeah.
Or does God want me to sit next to this woman and pray for her? Instead of questioning, like, why is she in my seat? I turn it around and go, what do I need to do in this situation?
At that time, I never thought of that.
Yeah.
See? So change.
You would
now,
know, though.
Yeah. Now I would. So that's change within me. But before, it was like, okay, well, I'm just going to confront her. I'm just going to tell her, hey, by the way, you got 1,800 seats and you're sitting in my seat. So I've changed.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. I've changed my thought process. If you look at the world, we're changing and really revolving in a people of less love. It's very obvious. The kindness and the care for each other is, it's changing.
Mm.
You know, the moral compass is going in a different direction.
Yeah.
And it's challenging to be amongst that sometimes. So you just have to remember that, hey, we're not in charge. We're not in charge of this world, and God knows what's going on. And that's maybe that's a change for you, that you can see something that it just doesn't seem right for you. And maybe God is talking to you that this year I want you to come to me. This year I would like to see you experience me more. And maybe that is for not only for you, but for your family. You know, we're in challenging, tough times. Things are going to close down. Maybe you haven't worked in a little while. And maybe God has something else for you, maybe to explore. and try. Mm-hmm. So, you know, going back to praying. All right, I'm going to try. Maybe I don't pray. I don't know how to pray. It's a simple conversation.
Yeah.
Just like we're talking today. You just talk to God just like you're listening to us and we're talking on the radio. Mm-hmm. And he's going to hear you. So maybe you haven't done that in the past. So maybe it's time for you to get out of the boat and make a change.
Mm-hmm. And if you'd like to share that change of heart that God's impressed on you that he's done in your past and how he's helped pull you out of that, you know, systematic habit that's been really hard on you, call us at 1-800-721-9313 or locally 928-855-9110. You know, I was thinking about how I relate to, because it's hard for me to comprehend how the Lord loves us. So I always go back to, because I'm a parent, how the Father's heart is towards us. That's how my heart is, except a million times more towards my children. So my son is probably the most stubborn human on the face of the planet. His teacher, one of my dear friends, describes him as the iron will, because he is. So I watch him struggle with that, with change. And I know that's part of, you know, where he's at. He's 10 years old. So that's part of it too. But watching him and going, son, this is going to be good for you to struggle through this. I'm going to allow you to struggle through this. I'm not going to step in. I'm going to allow you to figure this out on your own. That must be how God looks on us while we're struggling with change and trying to make, you know, to do that. It's not going to be perfect. We're not going to step out and go acknowledge and go, okay, now I've got it figured out. That's not how it works. Right, Mike?
Yeah. I know it's hard though. Mm-hmm. You know, and I imagine it's hard for you as a parent having to, I remember being a kid and you have to learn a lesson.
Yeah.
To change, don't touch the stove, and you know, you just kind of, well, why? And then all of a sudden you figure out why, and okay, you're going to change that thought process. But you know, I think change is being taught. It's a taught process. I like things in line. I like, mm-hmm. I like the way they are. I like routine and things like that. And I seem to be taught just the opposite from leaders, that they were changing stuff up all the time. And I was thinking, why do we have to do this? Or why are we doing that? Why can't we? And I like that because it got me out of the old mindset thinking of this is just the way it is. And you know, the question is, how come we're doing this, or why can't we change to that? And well, the standard answer would be, well, that's the way we've always done it. Mm-hmm. And change is not that way. It's not the way you've always done it. So I learned that change was exciting.
Yeah.
And I began to embrace change, and you never know. Now, if you come to Hilltop Celebrate Recovery, we change things every week.
Mm-hmm.
You never know what to expect. And I learned that a lot through a past couple of pastors. And Pastor David is one that changes stuff up all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And it's given me a newness, an excitement, instead of trying to be the rebel that just says, well, you know, why do we have to do this, or why are we doing that? I've learned that I've grown and been so excited about the change, mm-hmm. that it's changed me.
Yeah.
It's given me that, which I like because I'm an old guy, but it's kept my enthusiasm up, that mm-hmm. excitement, and what people think and see of the change and the newness. Now, you know, a lot of times, you know, people are stuck in their way and they're not going to change, period.
Right. Well, you know what's interesting about that too? It's not just, you know, God created us so masterfully. When we do something over and over again, there's science that backs this up. We're creating muscle memory. Yeah, and we're creating that neural pathway in our brain to go over and over and over again. That's why it's so hard with addictions, because you have to make that intentional choice to change and then continue that new good behavior to override that old path that's been dug into the dirt over mm-hmm. and over and over again in our brain. So that's why it's mm-hmm. so difficult to institute those changes in your life. But I'm telling you, keep at it and don't stop before the miracle happens, because it will.
Yes. Yeah. I that's funny you said that, because I look back and I look at about the million times that I tried to fix myself to make that change, but I never changed. It was always, it would always go back to the addiction, the drinking, the drugging, the womanizing, the adultery, the porn.
Yeah.
And it was challenging to try different things to try and change that behavior, but always went back to that behavior.
Mm-hmm.
So you got to fill that void with something else, and that's Jesus Christ. I'm telling you.
That's right.
I mean, that's bottom line.
There's no faster way to get back to baseline than making Jesus the center of your life.
Yeah.
You can go straight to him each time, and he, it's miraculous what he does in your heart and your mind if you do it with a full open heart, right? I just wanted to also say, Christine, one of our guests that we had, who has been a survivor of cancer, and she went through her whole chemotherapy treatment and everything. She wants to say hi to everybody. So I want to put a shout out to Christine. If we could all keep her and her family in our prayers.
She's a talk about a warrior.
Talk about
God has changed her upside down and left and right. And she is one who cares and loves on people and gives and does. But through that, she's had many challenges with illness and cancer and on, and just recently got COVID. And you just think, wow, how could someone have so much? And it's within the courage of trusting God to make that change, to trust the process.
That's right.
I look at that now because I remember my newness within Jesus And I had many conversations with God, and I could see that he wanted me to go one direction, and I kept on telling him, no, you don't know me. This isn't going to work out too good. I don't want any of the spotlight. I'm a behind-the-scene guy. I'll come early. I'll stay late. I'll do this and that. And that just didn't work out for months, and finally I said, okay, I see what you're trying to do, but you'll see this isn't going to work out too good. And
you know, that reminds me of an old guy in the desert that ran from Egypt.
Yeah.
Spent 40 years, you know, herding sheep.
Yep.
Yeah. He tried the same thing with God.
I know.
And you know what happened with him.
I do.
It didn't work.
I know.
Yeah.
So now I've embraced every bit of change that he wants me to do. Because here's the thing. Can you see tomorrow?
Well, no.
We can't see 10 minutes from now.
You're right.
Yeah.
But God can see tomorrow and next week and next year. So a lot of times you'll do things and it doesn't seem to quite make sense. But then when you get to the other side of that, you go, wow, okay. Wow, that's amazing.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We got a caller. Good morning. Welcome to Recovery Radio.
Good morning.
Who's this?
Christine.
Well, good morning to you. First of all, how are you feeling?
I'm actually feeling better. I'm on the, I think, eighth day of COVID.
Okay.
So, and then my husband came down, I thought was COVID yesterday, but he got tested for the flu. So now he's like sick. So I've done laundry all day yesterday. Mm.
Wow.
Well, that's good. See, Bill didn't get to that because he didn't wear his shirt today. So see that, Christine?
She's doing laundry and she has COVID.
That's right.
Bill.
Yeah.
Bill doesn't do his laundry I have.
Okay. Maybe you need to change that.
There could be a change in your life, Bill.
No, Bill's not doing the laundry. I buy the soap. I paid them. You know, I bought the machines. Not my job. So.
It's not that hard. You just throw you it tell in them, the
Christine. Thank you.
Yeah, I know. Yes. We got these new the digital everything on them. You push a button, it looks like a DVD player.
I know
the play button on there, and yeah, I've done it. I put stuff in there and pressed the button before, but I just that's something that I just don't like doing.
Okay. Well, my husband does laundry.
Hmm.
Well, I am proud of him.
Probably the first 6 days of COVID, he washed my sheets every single day and put clean sheets on my bed for me.
That's awesome.
Because I was sweating.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, that's good. So, Christine, what are you, what is your direction for your thought process of something that you're going to change or beginning to work on and change this year?
Well, first I want to say it's very hard watching your children go through things that you went through when you were their age and they don't listen to you.
Yeah.
It's so hard to watch them go through and you just want to say, look, it's, you know, I'm older than you and I know what you're going through, and but, you know, you have to let them go through. And that when Val said watching her son go through and let him work it out, it just went boing.
Yeah. I don't think that's ever going to change, because as teenagers, I mean, I know I had all the answers.
Yeah. I know.
So,
yeah.
You know, our parents weren't that smart.
Can you
imagine?
Because
when you become a teenager, you are a genius.
Right. And can you imagine how God feels looking down on all his children? Yeah. I mean,
that's why I know he has a sense of humor.
And he doesn't get frustrated. Yeah. He just, you know, he knows it's going to be good. So
I know. And he keeps trying to direct me going places, and I'm not quite sure. I know I started feeling better after cancer. I was putting a lot of hours in at work, and I think he kind of slowed me down again. I had surgery on the 23rd, and then I became allergic to all the glue that they used on me, so I had a rash all over my torso and back. It's like horrible. And then I caught COVID on December 31st, so now I'm back at home with the door. My store closed. Not even open. David missing 2 weeks worth of work. Yeah, it's been fun. Yeah.
Story of Job comes to mind for me with all of this.
Yes.
Talk about change.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
No, he's trying to really make me change to go somewhere, to do something, and I'm not getting it. So I'm trying to be open. Mm-hmm. And listen, and I'm not mad at anything. I'm actually, God's got this. Whatever his plan is, I know it's better than my plan. And so I'm even comfortable if I lost everything. I'm okay, because God's got a plan for me.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know what it is, but someday maybe I'll get it.
You know, as you're speaking, Christine, I'm thinking about how I used to be, I didn't trust anybody. And I hear in your mind how much you trust the Lord with your life, and you're so willing to follow him in that. Even if we're frustrated in the time and we don't understand what he's doing, we trust him. And it took me a while to build my trust with my Heavenly Father before I could do that. So I love that your willingness, your surrender, and the knowledge that you know God has good plans for your future.
I do. I just wish you could just sit right next to me and just look me in the eye and go, do this.
Yeah. Okay, here's what we're going to do.
Yeah. Boing,
that would be nice.
Yeah. Because sometimes you're in your mind, you're going, okay, is that of him or is that of Satan?
Mm. Yes.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
And it's kind of...
Is it just me? Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, or, you know, yeah, it's just me, you know, and I want to do his will. And I know his will for me is not to work around the clock, so he had to slow me down again. And I'm just like when I had my car accident, he did the same thing to slow me down. Mm-hmm. So
So maybe your change is to slow the
slow
pace.
Slow down, yeah.
Because sometimes we get so busy, don't we? And we just think we're doing so many things, and I got this, and I
priorities,
got that.
Priorities, different,
and
yeah.
You got to juggle so many different plates, and that's because we think that that's what we have to do. And
mm-hmm.
Then plates start to fall, and we wonder why. And you know, God's getting our attention, and he wants us to look over to the left side instead of to the right side, and we just get caught up in so many things.
Mm-hmm. And like Mike was saying earlier, the Lord is very clear. There's no confusion mm-hmm. either way. It's black and white. Mm-hmm. It comes from the Word, and it's, you know, that's part of it too, I think, Christine. When I'm getting something and I feel like I'm questioning, where is this coming from? You know, I'm going to dig a little deeper and see, is this really from mm-hmm. God?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I want to remind you of Psalm 46:1. That says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
And that's what I'm getting from you, Christine. That, yeah, that's, you know, what you're looking
and
at.
And he does. He. I want to tell the listeners that God just loves us so much. He knows everything about us.
Right.
You know what I mean? And he cares about everything we do and the direction that we're going. And the more you listen or follow to the direction that he has, I'm telling you, the better your life is.
Yeah.
It just is. You may walk through the mud and think this is just ridiculous. But when you get to the other side of that and turn around and he hoses you off and cleans you up, you just go, you realize that there was such a purpose of going through the mud. Now, if you relied on yourself, you would have never done that.
Yeah. Right.
And right. You would have never had the reward that's over here. Wow, I get to do this now. And, so I've experienced that so many times. And, I'm thankful to embrace change because I know change brings newness. And newness brings an excitement to keep me young at heart and a new challenge and new people. And maybe that's exactly what he has for you, a whole new profession. We don't know.
No,
it's exciting though.
Yeah,
when you know that he's making changes in your life, and okay, how come you're making changes? What do I have to do? Because I got something different and exciting coming up.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people just plow through that, and they actually miss that.
Miss the opportunity.
That's right.
Yeah.
No, God is good. My marriage is so strong.
Mm. Yeah. Amen. Now. Amen. Yes.
Yes. So it's been. Whole 15, 16 months, whatever I've been on, has been a ride, but it's been the best ride.
Yes.
It really has been. It's been terrible, but it's been the best.
Yes.
That makes sense.
Yes, it does. Sure does.
Perfect.
I hope the listeners are hearing Christine right now. She is a woman who has been through the ringer, and she's saying right now to everybody that it's been the best ride.
Yeah.
So that's God changes our heart and our perspective of while we're going through. We're not going to not have challenges when we surrender our life to the Lord. In fact, we probably will have more challenges, but it's how we approach them.
It's a change of attitude a lot of times too.
Absolutely.
Did you ever hang around a person that glass is half empty and they're going to be miserable and no matter what, that glass is half empty and they're in the doom and gloom and it's not fun being around that. On the opposite side, that glass not changing and still being half, God can change your whole outlook within just that simple process. And you just go, wow, that glass is half full. I'm excited. I have half. Half right now, right?
You just need to find that one little positive thing on whatever horrible thing you're going through. If you just grasp at one little positive thing in that circumstances you're in and grasp onto that, and it'll help you get through it. Help you get through whatever you're going through, looking for that one positive thing.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
Well, amen. Christine, we love you. Thank you so much. We're praying for you.
You're awesome.
Get healthy, stay healthy.
Amen.
And we will we'll talk to you soon.
Okay. All right. Bye, you guys. Love
bye-bye.
You.
Love you.
Bye-bye.
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 Y'all hear that? She trained her husband to do the laundry.
Laundry, Bill.
That is fascinating.
I mean, there is hope.
I need to get with her and learn.
I know how to do laundry. It's just I don't want to.
Yes. See, God can change that don't want to, too.
Yes. Well, I'm hoping he doesn't.
You just heard some of my story. So for you men out there shaking your head going, I'm not doing laundry.
Well, look out. There's a change coming, y'all.
Look out. We don't know. You know, I think of so many of our shut-ins, that are going through, the fear. And now you just see so much of the doom and gloom on the news, and things are falling apart, and there's a new strain of COVID, and on. It's just I walk around and people with masks, and we're not ourselves. I think we're almost like caged lions per se. People don't seem super friendly. it's a miserable wearing a mask, having parameters. I don't know about you, but I'm kind of a conversation person, and you have to stand farther away from people, and people are almost annoyed if you get too close, and so it's, you know, just on a daily routine of, say, going to the bank, because they have to go to the bank, it's a whole different experience now. And that might be
there's actually people wearing masks in banks
everywhere.
Before, that was weird.
Yes.
You know.
So, you know, our society and the events that have taken place for the past year have been traumatic for people. Mm-hmm. And it's out of the norm. And that's a big change.
Yeah.
Some changes aren't for the positive. Right. They're for the negative. And we have to remember that.
Yeah.
And so... the more we, I think, fight it and squawk about it and how horrible it is, I still sing and everything else. And I'm still that happy guy going through the supermarket and shopping and stuff like that.
I'm not going to let that
beat me up or get me down, because, listen, I'm breathing, I'm walking, and I'm talking.
Yeah. And you have the hope of Jesus living in you.
That's
eternal life. Yeah.
I mean,
that's
it. Listen, this is a pit stop. That's all it is. We're not going to be here for much longer. You know, I'm getting older, and here's the thing: everybody dies.
Yeah.
Everybody.
Yeah.
At one point in time, so the more I think you go with the flow, the easier it is on your mind and your body. Mm-hmm. And the more you're willing and you become trainable or teachable that to embrace change.
Yeah. So the way that I love that you just said that, embrace change, because it's an action. It's intentional. Mm-hmm. I remember when I was going through all my changes, I was in an inpatient rehab. And one of the things they explained to me was, I'm going to have challenges, and it's going to be harder for me now that I'm not using my old coping skills of numbing out and disconnecting, using drugs or whatever, emotional disconnection. Mm-hmm. Some of the things that I used or tried to control, food intake, all of that, I had to let go of all those because they were damaging to me and they were harming the people around me as well. I was causing a lot of destruction. So in that, I had to choose to not, I couldn't manage my circumstances. I could only change my perspective of those circumstances, because they're going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
But trying to manage the circumstance, it never played well for me in trying to change.
Yeah. And if you were now, you know, we'll tell the listeners now, you were in a rehab for 90 days.
Yep.
And so to change, now you can rely on yourself and saying, you know, I just got to get through this and get out of here, or embrace the fact that you have opportunity now.
Yes.
Because the way you were doing it wasn't working out too well. The way I did it didn't work out too well.
Yeah,
so,
same here.
So, you know, God brings forth opportunity for you to grow, and which is changing your ways, and he gives you opportunity to see things in a different light. And I tell you what, when you begin to do that, when you begin that process, that is huge, huge change.
Yes.
And you will see results, and you will feel results, and so won't everybody else in your family.
That's right.
And it's nice. I mean, to watch where you've been just in a short time, and what God has done in your life, and who you've become has been exciting for me.
Yeah, absolutely.
You're a different person.
Yep. That's
so
right.
And you just throw yourself under the bus and go tell people all the time, and I love that.
Yes.
I say
he's
going like,
to use that. He's yes, going to use he, all that,
and he
pain.
Will. And people will look at you because you, to be honest, you have that sweet innocent look, Val, and you know, I mean, I don't have that look, but you have that, and then you speak of your journey, and people just—I could see it. Just
the power
go,
of
Lord.
Jesus
Holy
Christ.
You,
the redeeming power of Jesus Christ. That's what it is. It had
it
nothing
is.
To do with me. It had everything to do with what He did for me.
Yep.
And He rescued me.
Yep. And the more we share, I call myself a piece of glass. The more we share, the more people can see. The more people can see what God has done in my life.
That's
not Mike. Yeah.
Yes,
it's all God. So change may be following directions, you know, just as simple as that.
Yep.
We'd love to hear from you.
That's right. 1-800-721-9313 or 928-855-9110. We have time for at least one more caller, so please call in and speak with us.
You know, you guys were talking about perspective, and this has been rolling around in my brain for the whole show, and I just wanted to share it. You know, a lot of Christians, if not all of us at one point in time, have seen God as this massive thing that fills the universe, and preachers are saying we can't put him in a box and all of that. But what we don't remember is that he's also a friend that sticks closer than a brother. He's constantly there with you, no matter what you're going through. And Christine, he is sitting on the couch next to you.
Yeah,
you just gotta remember that he wants to be everything for you. Your best friend, your father. I mean, he wants you to have that relationship with him. And that's what this whole life that we live is about.
Yeah.
Building that relationship with our Heavenly Father.
Amen.
He wants to be Abba, Father. He wants to be Daddy. And being a father myself of seven children, I've had the opportunity to experience a little taste of what God feels for each and every one of us. Mm-hmm. And it's because of that love that Jesus came, and the reason we just celebrated Christmas just not even a month ago mm-hmm. was so he could die on a cross for us. Mm-hmm. And that we're going to be celebrating Easter in a few months. So it's all about the relationship. Mm-hmm. With him. Mm-hmm. And no matter what you're going through, remember, he's there with you. Amen. And it has to go through him first in order for it to go to you.
Yeah. Yeah. Amen.
Wow. I like when Bill speaks. It's very profound. What he just said about the relationship, that just went straight to my heart. Thank you so much for sharing that, Bill.
You're welcome. Amen. You know, our hour is almost over, and you know, we hope that you. I know.
Yes.
We hope that somehow we have helped you today, maybe inspired you today. And we've got some more sponsors. We also want to thank.
That's right. Just Garage Doors, now hiring, located at 2555 North Kiowa Boulevard, Suite 100, by phone 928-855-6331. Sunshine RV Experience, sales and service at its best with Kyle and the gang, located at 2995 Maricopa Avenue. They have a new Northside location on Highway 95 near Dillard's, at the shops, on the web at sunshinerv.com, or by phone 928-855-6648. We also have Surf Pro of Lake Havasu City, Bullhead City, and Kingman, family owned and operated residential and commercial restoration and cleaning services, located at 2775 Kiowa Boulevard North, by phone 928-855-9124, or on the web, ServPro Lake Havasu City, Bullhead City, Kingman.com. And we'd also like to thank Hilltop Community Church for supporting Recovery Radio with the shirts and hats, and they're located at 3180 McCulloch Boulevard North, on the web at hilltoplhc.com.
Amen. And don't forget that you can contact us, get a hold of us at recoveryradiolhc.com.
Mm-hmm. That's right. So you can contact us, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts. You can hear the shows, YouTube, Facebook, and then...
There's a lot of them. There really is. Yeah. So you can get a hold of us in so many different ways.
That's right.
You know, we just want to thank you so much for today's program.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Bill.
Thank you, Val.
Thank you to our producer, Pat, out there, and Polly and Tom today in the studio. A couple of shout-outs, Buddy listening, Randy in Florida, and Billy in Bullhead, and gotten a lot of texts today. People have enjoyed the show, and we just thank you for listening.
Mm-hmm. And our winner today is Sherry for a t-shirt or hat. So yay, Sherry.
Hey, Sherry. Okay. Mm-hmm. Good job.
I'd like to close us out in prayer if
I could.
That
would be great, Val. Thank you.
Heavenly Father, we ask for your guidance as we seek to make positive changes this year. Help us to strive to be closer to you and seek your will in everything we do. We give you all the glory, honor, and praise in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Val. And remember, keep coming back. We'll see you on the radio next week. And hopefully we really will see you on the radio.
That's right.
We'll be
they'll see us on the radio.
Up and running. And we'll do a live simulcast visually so that you can also see Val's beautiful face
as I talk about,
right?
Yeah.
That's right.
So remember, we're better together. I'm your host, Mike, and we will see you on the radio next week. Have a blessed week.
And if I could remind everyone to please keep Miss Debbie and the Tatham family in prayer. Mm-hmm. They need it today.
Amen.
Goodbye from Recovery Radio, where we have hope for you. I'm not you.